gracia. Señor, contenta estoy, enamorada de ti. Razones de por qué te quiero. Esas razones que tu amor solo logrará.
Bienvenidos a su programa La Rancherita and Friends Ministries. Aquí estoy y no me voy de nuevo aquí el sabadito lindo, domingo, ya me estoy equivocando de días. Pero hay muchas razones, ¿verdad? Como dice el canto, hay muchas razones de por qué estar agradecida con Papi Dios, porque Él nos da vida, primeramente nos da salud. Y si no tienes salud, te voy a decir que en el nombre de Jesús hay el poder. Como dice el canto, hay poder, poder, sin igual poder. Que Jesús es el que vino y murió en la cruz del Calvario por nosotros para que tengamos vida y vida eterna. Siempre predicamos o hemos oído escuchar mucho a predicadores, ¿verdad? Durante las generaciones de que predican salvación en San Juan 3:16. Y es muy, me estaba pensando yo en eso, que dice que porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And we know that throughout the generations, many preachers, evangelists, and what have you that are ministering the word of God have preached on John 3:16. And it is saying very clear that whosoever, you're the whosoever, if you believe in God, if you believe in Him, that He is the one that created this world, and you need Him, just ask Jesus Christ into your life. El San Juan 3:16, St. John 3:16, San Juan 3:16, lo dice bien claro, porque tanto amó Dios al mundo que dio a su Hijo unigénito para todo aquel que en Él crea, no se pierda, mas tenga vida eterna. No está poniendo condiciones. God is not putting conditions. He's just saying, if you believe. Él no está diciendo que tienes que ser miembro de una iglesia. No está diciendo que tienes que dar mucho dinero. No está diciendo que por obras. Él lo está haciendo muy simple aquí, que dice que si crees en el Hijo de Él. He's not putting conditions that... It's all about money, it's all about your deeds and what you're doing. It's all about grace, and he's just saying, whosoever believes in Christ. All you have to do is believe in Jesus Christ. Todo lo que tienes que hacer es creer en su Hijo Jesucristo. And in Jesus, there's the power, people. Those of you that are listening to me this morning, there is the power in the name of Jesus. Hay poder en el nombre de Jesús. Todo el poder está en Él. Él llevó todo en la cruz para que nosotros fuéramos librados hoy. He took and carried everything in the cross so that we could be free today. And I don't know how much more to emphasize that he's making it very simple. Él lo está haciendo tan sencillo y tan simple. And I do set this as an example. You know, the thief that was next to him in the cross. He told him, you will be with me today in paradise. Él le dijo al ladrón en la cruz que estaba en silla de él, le dijo, hoy vas a estar conmigo en paraíso. Él no tuvo tiempo de ser miembro de una iglesia. El ladrón no tuvo tiempo. The thief didn't have a time, that criminal didn't have time to become a member of a church. And you know, by grace, God says it very clearly. Por gracia, Dios lo dice muy claro. Gentes que me están escuchando, amigos y amigas, brothers and sisters that are listening to me, he made it very clear that by grace we are saved. Es por gracia, hermanitos lindos. And I just want to share that because this program is about sharing Jesus Christ and putting some music videos. It's about giving you hope. Es para darle esperanza a usted que me está escuchando. Este es su programa, La Ranchita and Friends. Es ministrando o hablando de Jesús, promoviendo el nombre de Cristo, lifting up the name of Jesus, ensalzando a Jesucristo, levantando el nombre de Él, porque Él se lo merece todo. If you're a follower of Jesus Christ, tell your friends about Him. Si tú eres seguidor de Jesucristo, comparta tus experiencias con el prójimo, con tus amistades, tu familia. No se avergüencen del Evangelio, ¿eh? You should not be ashamed of the gospel. Just share Jesus Christ with others. Muchos ahorita, ¿verdad?, se están muriendo de enfermedades. A lot of people are perishing or they're dying because they're sick. And they have lost hope. Para usted que ha perdido esperanza, I got good news for you. For those of you that have lost hope and feel very hopeless right now, the key to you being set free right now is the name of Jesus. La esperanza para usted ahorita es el nombre de Jesucristo. En Proverbios capítulo 3, versículos 5 y 6, Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him and He will direct thy path." Confía en el Señor en todo, de todo corazón, y no en tu propia inteligencia. Reconócelo en todos sus caminos y Él allanará tus sendas. Or He will guide your path. Seek the Lord with all of your heart, people. You know, confía en, it's about trusting the Lord. Es, todo está en confiando en Jesucristo. It's about trusting God. We need to trust God. And lean not unto your own understanding, because if we do that, we'll get in trouble. We need to acknowledge Him in all of our ways, and He will direct our path. Necesitamos decirle a Papi Dios, confiar en Él, platicar con Él, y Él nos va a dirigir nuestros caminos. Ahí lo dice muy clarito, que Él va a dirigir nuestros caminos. He will direct. Quiero que también... decirles y compartirles, ¿verdad?, de lo que hago para este ministerio. Como ha confiado yo mucho en Jehová y Él me ha sacado mucho, yo pasé por, I was going through real heavy trials for 7 months. Perdí todo, me quedé sin nada. I lost everything, and I went through heavy trials for 7 months. I lost everything, I had nothing. And God just opened doors for me, and I'm here now talking about the wonders of God. Ahora estoy aquí porque Él abrió este camino para mí. Yo oraba y le decía, Papi Dios, ¿qué hago? Lord, help me. What do you want me to do? What do I do? I have nothing. I don't know. I've lost my home. I've lost everything. Perdí todo. Perdí mi hogar. Perdí todo. Dije, ¿qué hago, Papi Dios? What would you have me to do, you know? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Todo lo puedo en Cristo que me fortalece, y no hay que ahogarnos en un vaso de agua. Let's not drown in a glass of water. Let's keep on preaching and telling people about Jesus. Si nos pasan cosas, y nos van a pasar porque todos vivimos aquí en este mundo, we will have crises happen to us because we live in this world. Jesus, it's a little easier, and we can cling to Him. Con Jesucristo es un poco más fácil, y podemos nosotros agarrarnos de la fuerza de Él y decir, todo lo puedo en Cristo que me fortalece. La fortaleza viene de Él. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, because the strength is given by Him to us. And like I said, it's all by grace. Todo es por gracia que Dios nos da, esto todo de su palabra que Él dice. Ahorita regresamos después de esto. Vamos para un video.
This journey through life may not be easy. The pathways may be rugged and hard. But the one who walked through before you
did no wrong, and his body was scarred. He was born in a lowly stable, and he lay where the cattle was fed. He had no bed with a soft, warm mattress, and no pillow to lay down his head. There is but one perfect man, his name is Jesus. He had no faults, no failures, no sins. But the whole world, they crucified him. He was forsaken by all of his friends. Jesus reached out to the blind man. He raised the young girl from the dead. Fed all the people who were hungry. His reward was the thorns on his head. So when you feel you've been mistreated, or in some way you've been shortchanged, look at this man, his name is Jesus. He was found guilty and he had no blame. There is but one perfect man, his name is Jesus. He had no faults, no failures, no sins. But the whole world rejected.
Estaré agradecida a Dios por una madre.
If you do have your moms alive, treat them with such respect and love and cherish the time with them. Mine has gone to heaven, but I will see her soon. Well, not that very soon. I hope I can be here longer. But traten a sus madrecitas ahorita que si las tienen vivas todavía, trátenlas bien con mucho amor, con respeto y agradezcan todo el momento que pueden con ellas. Nos vemos el próximo domingo. Aquí estoy y no me voy. Que Dios me los bendiga.
Say before people were called Christians, they were called the people of the way. They didn't know what else to call them because they were so unique. They weren't like religious people. Because people were coming from all over, various different pagans, not just Jews. Now, early on, it was pretty much just Jews, but Gentiles were being converted. And neighbor, this was before any denominations ever were formed. This is before even the Baptists. Now think about that. John was a Baptist. John the Baptist. But as far as a denomination, there were no denominations at that time. There were no squabbles and fights among God's people. Now they did have them later on in the early church, but we won't get into that today. But that's human nature, isn't it? But I'd like to share with you just for a few moments from the book of Acts. The Acts of the Holy Spirit is what it's called, but it's also the Acts of the early Christians, the people of the way. I would like to share from Acts chapter 16. And we're going to title this Jailhouse House Rock because it took place with a lot of hostages. You know, that's on our mind today. What are we going to do with hostages? Those who have been taken against their will and imprisoned, some of them killed and murdered. We're going to call this Jailhouse Rock today because there were some early Christians that did not allow the circumstances of life to deter their eternal calling and purpose. And maybe something that we share today will inspire you and me to stay in the fire, stay in the fight, stay on the firing line, and don't give up, no matter how much comes against us, no matter what we face in the days ahead. Maybe looking back to the days when this thing first got started, before they were even known as Christians, think about it. They were people of the way. And I'm going to start reading in the book of Acts, and you'll understand why we call this message Jailhouse Rock. There are hostages taken. In verse 22, and the multitude rose up together against them, people of the way, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. Now we're talking about the religious crowd. This is the religious leaders of the day. Nothing's changed, has it? And the magistrates rent off their clothes. Have you ever been so mad that you grit your teeth? And you say things to people that you normally would not say. I've seen religious people do that. Mm-hmm. They would never do that to their boss. But boy, they have a license when they're in the church. Okay, let's go on. Verse 23, and when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. You know what that meant in case something happened? The jailer's response was to make sure that the hostages remained intact, ready to be negotiated with. And the jailer, verse 24, who having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison or the dungeon. Because he knew that his very life was at stake if something happened and they were somehow able to escape. So he put them in the deepest, darkest, nastiest part of the prison, where the real criminals were. And he not only did that, but he made their feet and their hands in the stocks. Can I show you what it looked like? not just handcuffs and ankle. They put him in the stocks. This was serious business. If that was me, most of the time, I'd be whining and complaining and saying something like this. Well, thanks a lot, Lord. I've been serving you all my life. I've tried to. Far from perfect, but you know, I've been doing my best. Hello? What am I doing here? How many of y'all can identify with that? You're not going to raise your hand. I don't know. Well, let's read it. Verse 25. Everybody say it with me. At midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, verse 26. Move over, Elvis. This is the real jailhouse rock. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. Y'all still believe in miracles? Mm-hmm. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have committed Harry Carey or killed himself. You know what that means. Supposing that the prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, you don't need to do that. We're all still here. Do thyself no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light. Remember, we're in the pitch dark of midnight. So he called for a light and sprang in and came trembling. Would that shake you up? Let's do Elvis songs. Jailhouse Rock, and I'm all shook up. And a little Jerry Lee Lewis too, huh? A whole lot of shaking going on. Y'all just got it, didn't you?
Yes.
He came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas, and he brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And so they said, "You got to become a good Jehovah's Witness." You got to give at least 10% to the. No, wait, that's not it. Well, you're going to have to go to catechism, and you're going to have to do the rosary. Oh, and you've got to take communion. And it really would help if you became a good Baptist. Oh, no, Methodist. Mormon. No, man. You got to get the Holy Ghost. You got to run around the building and you got to become a Pentecostal. You got to learn how to dance in the water. This predates it all. God knows we need some good Baptists and Methodists and Pentecostals. God knows that. It's not that folks are evil. I'm not saying denominations are evil. I'm just saying this predates it all. God has a lot of patience and understanding. He knows how we just are not all going to become Republicans.
Today's the final day to clean their
I triggered a phone. Stella, that's funny.
I'm sorry.
We went to high school together over 50 years ago. She was the drum major in the band. And you're still just as pretty as you were back then.
Amen. Thank
you. Stand up, sorry. Stand up. This is one of my schoolmates. She knew me back then. Stella, thank you. Love you, girl. Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
Are you getting it?
Yeah.
This predates it all. Sirs, why do I have to get what you got? How many know that there's nothing we can do in ourselves to be good enough to get to heaven without Jesus?
That's right. Yes.
And there's nobody here or anywhere else that have been so bad, done so many horrible things in your life, that they can come and say, God, I have been a mess in my life. I have made so many mistakes. Would you please forgive me? Dying for the sins of the world, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and your whole family too.
Amen.
Your whole family.
Your whole family too. And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in the house. And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, he and all of his family, straightway. And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them, and rejoiced, believing in God with all of his house. What's rocking your world? What has rocked you in your lifetime? What kind of baggage have you been carrying? What kind of burdens have you been carrying? Maybe you even were misunderstood by your church where you grew up. Maybe your pastor didn't quite get you. Maybe your spouse was a sorry lot. Mm-hmm. What's rocking the world of your kids and your grandkids and your great-grandkids? Religion is not going to fix it. Politics is not going to fix it. My wife and I, when we pray for our kids and our grandkids, we pray something like this. Father, you know each and every one of them, from the oldest, Daniel, to the youngest, Jason, what is he, 3? And all those in between. Father, I don't pray that, we don't pray that they become nice and religious choir boys. And they're not. they're tough. They're tough. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that in their hearts and in their minds, they will have a hunger to know you personally and intimately. You alone have to draw them to yourself. My nagging, your nagging, your preaching at your kids has not done it and will not. Don't try to be the Holy Spirit. Sure. Are you listening to me?
Amen.
I don't mean to be so. But folks, listen. The answer is not in religion.
That's right.
But it is in the Holy Spirit drawing them. He knows their name. He knows everything about them. And he knows the struggles that they're going through. The Holy Spirit, you can trust Him. Amen. And He is not an it.
Amen.
He's a person just like the Father and the Son.
Amen.
And let's address Him the way He should be dressed.
Sure.
Let's pray right now for your kids and grandkids. Take hands of the person next to you. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we come today. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your love, Father. Thank you that we're all imperfect. There's no perfect parent. There's no perfect grandparent. There's no perfect husband. There's no perfect wife. There's no perfect teenager. There's no perfect child. But God, your word and your Holy Spirit, you said, Lord Jesus, you said that I must go away. But if I go away, I will send him to you and he will come alongside and help you and be in you. And he shall lead you into truth. So, Father, I pray for all of the family members that are represented under the sound of my voice today. I pray for those children, those grandchildren, and those great-grandchildren, and the spouses that are represented here today. Father, in the name of your holy child, Jesus, would you please send your Holy Spirit into the lives and send a great awakening in our country and our world. And let it begin with us. And for those of you who may be here today, you don't have any children. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Your influence over your lifetime has brought children into the kingdom of God, and you will be amazed when we get into glory. How many people are going to come up to you and say, because you were faithful, because you prayed for me, because you sang a song that touched the heart. Maybe I didn't run down at the front of the altar, but maybe out under a palm tree or in the trailer somewhere, I grabbed that old Bible and I dusted it off, and I was able to understand it maybe for the first time in decades. I understand, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For he came into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. And now, Father, send forth your Holy Spirit into the lives of the family members represented under the sound of my voice today. And do what only your Holy Spirit can do. And not religion, not the Baptist, not the Methodist, not any denomination or any sectarian religious group, but only the Holy Spirit of God can change, still change lives today. Can you all say amen and amen?
Amen.
Can you agree that God is doing it?
Amen.
You have not because you ask not. Ask and you shall receive. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asks receives, and he that asks shall receive. And he that knocks, the door shall be opened unto
Amen.
Them.
Amen.
Notice what it said again. Sirs, what must I do to have what you got? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved and your whole family. And they then went out and got baptized. That's important too. But just remember, that old thief on the cross, he didn't have time to come down and go get baptized. He didn't have time to raise some money for the good cause. For the new building project, he just didn't have time, did he? But Jesus said, today, you'll be with me in paradise. He did all the hard work. Can you believe it?
Mm-hmm.
Can you receive
Amen.
It?
Yeah.
Can you believe? Don't get on the phone and fuss at your kids. Don't get on the phone and nag them. Just sit back and say, God, if you're God, if that's right, that guy up there on that stage sings and acts dumb and silly, and sometimes it's just, I don't get him. But if what you said and what he read in that book, if you can do all that, I'm going to rest. I'm going to trust you the best I know how.
Amen.
And I'm going to rest.
Amen. Yeah.
And I'm not going to try to do some religious manipulation. I'm going to rest. That the Holy Spirit
and watch what God will do.
Is moving
Amen.
In the lives of your family.
Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen. Let God be true, but every man a liar, is what the scripture says. God is true. He will do it. Trust him and see what God can do in your life and the life of your family. Can you say amen? Amen, brother. Preach on.
Que aman te cuidó.
in you. Ayúdame hoy, yo quiero saber lo que debo hacer. Muestra el camino que debo seguir. Señor, por mi bien, yo quiero vivir un día a la vez.
Yes, sir, baseball. razones que tu amor solo logrará.